Today, I'll show you how to use Claude AI, one of ChatGPT's biggest competitors. By the end of this video, you'll know how to tweak Claude's writing style to make it sound like you, tap into Claude's personality to actually get good advice, use Claude to learn how to code, and most important, know when Claude or ChatGPT is better for you. Now to access Claude, click the card at the top or use the link in the description. Let's dive in. From the homepage, enter your personal or work email and then click on Continue with Email or click on Continue with Google up above. Open your email and click on the sign in link to get here. Then enter your mobile phone number and confirm that you're at least 18 years of age. Click on Send Verification Code to verify your mobile number, and I'll see you on the other side. Select personal use if you see this screen. Answer these remaining questions and you're in. When you first get into Claude, you'll start hearing about different models. A good way to think about a model is where it sits on this chart. On the x-axis, you have cost, and on the y-axis, intelligence. You can think of intelligence as the model's performance on standard intelligence tests. You start with Claude 3 Haiku in the bottom left, then Claude 3 Sonnet is a little bit smarter, and Claude 3 Opus is a lot smarter. But Claude 3.5 Sonnet was recently released, making it the ideal balance of intelligence and cost. Now we're back on the main interface. Let's get you oriented. I'm using the professional plan, but you can follow along on the free plan. This is our prompt area, which is where we'll ask Claude to perform tasks for us. At the bottom of the prompt area, you can see this is how we change models. For this video, we'll stick with Claude 3.5 Sonnet. Let's write our first prompt together. Put your cursor inside the prompt area, and we'll ask Claude to write a suspenseful 200-word short story set in a rainstorm. Then press the Enter key to submit. And just like that, we've got a story. Claude can do other cool things too. Here's a photo that I took last year. I want to know the types of cows that are in this photo. So we can take the photo from our desktop and drop it inside the prompt area. Then we can ask Claude, what kinds of cows are in this photo? Press the Enter key again or click on the arrow to get the answer. And you'll see the response when you scroll down to the bottom. Now, every AI has its own personality or character. And it's interesting that in addition to answering the original question, Claude elaborated on the landscape and guessed where this picture was taken. Now, these are pretty simple prompts, so it shouldn't surprise you that ChatGPT can also answer them. So what's the difference? I'll take you through both pros and cons of Claude, but before we do that, check out something which is more subjective. I personally find that ChatGPT's responses are more robotic. They're usually in structured outlines and they include lots of lists like we see here. Claude, on the other hand, feels like I'm talking to a trusted advisor or professor. And in my experience, it tends to hedge its language more when it's unsure. But now onto more objective differences. First, let's start a new chat. Move your mouse cursor over to the left sidebar to pop it open. Then click on Start New Chat at the top. Let me now direct your attention towards choosing a writing style. We've been operating in normal Claude mode so far, but you can also tell Claude to be concise, explanatory, or even formal. Let's see the difference with the following prompt. I need some help writing an email to my boss, getting some time off after I pulled an all-nighter. Let's see what Claude can do. Let's scroll up to see the whole email. What do we have here? I'm writing to request taking off today, to recharge, thrilled about this success, updated our team calendar, da 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 da. Okay, it gets the point across, but it's a bit long. Let's try changing the writing style to concise, and then we can simply ask Claude to rewrite the email. Here's the rewrite, definitely more concise. Notice that you can highlight anything in this canvas and ask Claude to explain it or improve it through a new prompt. So now we've gone from too many words to too few. Concise isn't really the writing style that we want. And if we check the other writing styles, explanatory and formal don't really work either. Fortunately, you've got the ability to create your own style by clicking on Create and Edit Styles. Then click the large Create Custom Style button. The easiest way to create a style is to share examples of the style you're looking for. You can either upload a document or paste content directly. Let's paste some example emails. Once our content is entered, we'll click on Create Style. Now, Claude takes a few seconds to analyze and extract our writing style, so I'll see you in a bit. And here we are, this is the friendly coordinator style, blending personable communication with precise and proactive professional messaging. That's quite a mouthful. As you can see, I can rename the style by clicking on it, and I can edit the style directly by clicking on Edit with Claude. Here, I can use prompts to further qualify the style, or if I click Cancel here and then click on Options, I can click on Edit Style manually to see the exact instructions Claude will use. So let's see what happens. Click on Save Changes, then click on the X. We'll reset the style by clicking on the dropdown and then selecting Friendly Coordinator. Let's prompt Claude to rewrite the email one more time and see what happens. Well, third time's a charm. And actually, this email isn't too bad. There are a couple things that I don't like hope your morning is going well, this emoji, and ending the email with best. But I can continue to refine the writing style so those things don't show up again. Before we leave this canvas view, let me direct your attention to some of the options we have here in the bottom toolbar. Click the clipboard icon to copy everything in the canvas. Click the download icon to, guess what, download it. And click the publish button if you want to share this. Once an artifact is published, it looks like this. It's read-only, but other Claude users can remix it using the remix artifact button. Then it becomes an input to a new prompt that the user can manipulate. Now that we've talked about writing styles, let's talk about a common use of AI, and that's asking for advice. We're going to do a live comparison between Claude and ChatGPT to see what kind of advice you like best. First, let's clear this chat by going over to the sidebar and clicking Start New Chat. Then let's put these two AI bad boys side by side. Before we start with the prompt, we'll reset the writing style to normal. So here's the first situation, a theoretical ethical dilemma. It's a Robin Hood scenario. A man has robbed a bank, but he donates the money to an orphanage. If you know who committed the crime, do you tell the authorities or not? Let's see how they both respond. So both ChatGPT and Claude call out that this is an interesting ethical dilemma and that there are two main options. They also point out that there's some nuance and maybe some middle ground. But if we compare how they phrase, for example, option one, Claude presents this in a less robotic way. Remember how I said that Claude feels like a trusted advisor or mentor? This tone is the reason why. Let's try another scenario, this time less theoretical. Here's the situation. You work in an environment with a toxic coworker. This person was one of your teammates on a project and then took all the credit for your ideas. Your boss has assigned you to work with them again. So what would you do? Let's see what the AIs recommend. This time, ChatGPT has more to recommend than Claude. That said, Claude makes this feel more collaborative by asking you what elements of the situation concern you the most. Whether you prefer Claude's style of response or ChatGPT's is a matter of taste. Let's move on and talk about coding. First, we'll start a new chat in both environments. You already know how to do it in Claude, so in ChatGPT, I'll click on the new chat icon. If you've ever wanted to learn how to code, AI can be a great teacher. Let's say you wanted to learn how to use CSS to style a web page. So you decide to ask an AI to teach you using a playground. A playground is a live demo of some code, which makes it very easy to change that code and see the impact. Let me show you what I mean by asking these two AIs the same question. Now, there is a huge difference in how these two responded. Claude actually created a CSS playground for us, while ChatGPT told us how we can use an existing playground. Let's go full screen with Claude's response to see what this is all about. Now, all of these box properties and colors and text are ways to use CSS to style content. For example, I can change the border style of this box down below to dashed instead of solid. And the actual CSS code looks like this. When we updated the border to dashed, this generated CSS changed. Just so you see this live, let's try changing the font size. When we move the slider up top, watch this font size property down below. Here it goes up and back down. Now, if you want to see the code for this example, you can click on the code button in the top right. Unfortunately, this is not a live editor, so you don't have the ability to make changes here directly. But off camera, I did ask Claude, how do I change the code directly? And it created a new playground where I could edit the CSS directly. But in full transparency, I did have to ask it to fix its own bug. After it fixed it, we got this. So I can learn CSS through a real-world example, like changing the background color from white to yellow. Now that we've done some learning, let's have some real fun with this. For the sake of nostalgia, and also because it's cool, I'll ask Claude to show me how to make a Pong game. And in the preview, a Pong game appears. Let's see how good I am playing against myself. Terrible. This is clearly an area where Claude shines, but now let's talk about some of the drawbacks. I'll show you through one last new chat. And we'll put this side by side with ChatGPT once again. Here's the first issue. No image generation. Let's ask ChatGPT and Claude so you can see what happens. Claude very regretfully states that it can't do it, and ChatGPT creates the image. Here's the next big drawback. Claude can't access the internet. So if I once again ask them both a question, when did Dame Maggie Smith die? ChatGPT gives us the answer, which is a few months ago, and Claude thinks she's still alive. Now ChatGPT had these limitations too when it started, and it wasn't a deal breaker then. But this next limitation is a deal breaker for me, and that is message limits. See, you get a certain number of messages to send every 5 hours. If you pay for Claude Pro, which is their entry tier, and you have short conversations, you get about 45 messages in those 5 hours. Make those long conversations with lots of context, and that number could drop to 15. And that's 5 times the amount of messages that you get in the free version. So you might have even run into this message limit during this tutorial. And yes, ChatGPT has message limits on its paid plan too, but practically, I never run into them. And even if I did, there's a fallback plan. Even with these limits, you might find Claude worth it for coding, coaching, writing, and the rare case where ChatGPT lets you down. Now, do you think I'm being unfair to Claude? Light me up in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.